hier in Hilversum een hele speciale avond. 4 jaar geleden was hij al in onze studio en vanavond is het eindelijk weer zover.
Nou nog, Robbie Williams, als je die beelden net ziet, wat is het toch een lekker ding, hè? En 4 jaar geleden heb ik hier een kusje van hem gekregen. Hij is nog steeds om te zoenen. Dat vinden we toch ook hier in de zaal, hè? Hey!
Dit is RTL Boulevard. Ik ben Winston Gerstenoot en ik vraag jullie allemaal een groot applaus voor niemand minder dan Robbie Williams.
Hi, you doing, mate? Hi.
Well, Robbie, it's good to have you back.
It's good to be back.
Yeah. There are your fans sitting here. Not all of them. Not all of them.
nearly all of them. Hello, everybody. How you doing? Good to be back. Nice to see you.
Did you miss this the last 3 years? The applause and being there and...
I didn't think I did. But since being back at work and doing things, when people are excited to see you, it brings a smile to your face. So, you know, it's... Well, just before coming on, I was like, yeah, this is exciting. I remember doing this.
That minute is quite serious.
What?
Did you see it? The compilation of some footage you did?
Say yes.
Oh, yes,
it was beautiful.
It was my best work.
So we're going to talk about
it. Is it a sort of addiction, popularity, being recognized in the street?
No, I think just, you know, trying to make the best song that you can and hopefully people liking it is the addiction. And you know, and also, you know, I've had a very good ride. My career spanned over 20 years, and you know, you just hope that people keep buying your record and keep liking you and keep liking it. And that's the addiction in itself. I mean, why do you carry on doing TV shows?
But it's can imagine.
It's an addiction.
Well, it is.
I can imagine that there was a period where everybody, there was this point you said, I stop, I do nothing for a couple of years. Was there a point when you said to yourself, oh, this is a life I could lead?
No, because you get really, really bored. Mm. Incredibly bored. And if you don't do anything, you start to rot. And I was desperate to come back and do something because, you know, sitting on the sofa and watching the TV really doesn't fill you at all.
No.
And then you start thinking about a new album. At what point do you know, well, I want to make this kind of album? How do you develop something like that?
Well, the writing never stops. The writing has always been the hobby. And, you know, I've been writing most weeks for the last, you know, well, for the last 15 years, definitely. So the album's always been there. It's never been, right, what we're going to do or what we're going to make it sound like. You just go in and write the songs and then 12 of the best ones appear. And you put them on an album and hope people will like it.
And how do you write? You go into your room and start writing or scribbling down?
Well, it varies different ways. I mean, I can't play anything really, so I normally kind of do this with a keyboard. and it always sounds like Axel F to start off with. It's always dan, 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 dan. No, I can't do that one. Dan, 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 dan. Or, you know, I'll get a bass out, I'll make a bass line.
So it starts with music?
Most of the time, yeah. But how I've been working recently is with my friends from Stoke, where I'm from, and they're DJs, and we just get together and make backing tracks and sing over the top of them and try to come up with some words that are nice.
And is it when you say, I want this song on the album, that it comes on the album, or is there a discussion with a record company or a producer or something like that?
Well, there's a discussion with the producer this time. It's a guy called Trevor Horn, who's, you know, fantastic, world-renowned producer, and me and my friends got together, everybody that had heard the demos, and you know, there's about 6 or 7 of us that made a list of our top 20, because you know, I've written about 50 for this album, and we all come up with our lists, and then we comprise the lists, and then you take the list into Trevor Horn, and Trevor Horn goes, nope, no, no, yeah, that'll do. And you go, well, you're Trevor Horn, you know what you're doing. So.
And then this was the result, Reality Killed the Video
Reality
Star.
Reality Killed the Video Star,
We spoke earlier in September when the release was not yet there. How do you look back on these last 2 months? It's been a great success, I think.
Well, the album's been like the top-selling album in the world for the last 3 weeks. So, you know, I'm very, very happy.
Were you nervous about that? Were you nervous that, well, maybe it's going to drop like dead on the floor? The people won't pick it up.
Yeah, well, you know, you've seen countless times that, you know, people have been very, very successful and then dropped away into obscurity, never to be heard of again. And, you know, when you're away for 3 years, your mind can play tricks on you and you read a few things about yourself and you go, well, maybe it's true, maybe my time has passed. And, you know, and then release the album and evidently things are still going well. So yeah,
there was this specific point of a comeback, your performance in X Factor. And I read somewhere that this was kind of a nervous point, standing there behind backstage, and then you said to yourself, okay, this is one of these moments which are important for me.
Yeah, it was the first TV show back in Great Britain, and the X Factor is it's like the center of the universe over there. Yeah. It's huge, 14 million people are watching it each week. And I hadn't done anything for 3 years, and I was walking up to the stage, and I felt really confident, and I was surprised about how confident I felt. And then I was stood behind these screens waiting to go on, and oh yeah, this is all right. Mm-hmm. And then I thought, what are the words?
Yeah, really?
What? Oh my God. God gave me a son. God, what did God give me? God. And I shouted to the band, what did God give me?
Really?
And then the doors wouldn't open. And it was a very, very nerve-wracking time. But yeah, since then, everything seems to have gone very, very well.
Yeah, you worked on the album. In that period, something happened in the world of pop music, the death of Michael Jackson. Did you write something about that when you were working on this album?
Well, there's a song on the album called Morning Sun. It's the first song on the album. And my friends from Stoke wrote the whole thing. And I wanted to change a few lyrics, but I didn't know what to write about. And I just couldn't put a hook on it. And then Michael Jackson passed away, and I thought, oh, I know what I'll write about now. So the song, Morning Sun, is, you know, about Michael Jackson. And then a few months later, singing it back to myself, I realized that once again, it's another song about me, actually, so.
Well, what is the message in the song, then?
What's the message in the song?
Yeah. That it is about Michael Jackson and about you.
Am I singing it today? I don't know if I am.
No.
What's the message in the song? I don't really know.
Okay, to be honest with you.
Let's look at the moment that the whole world hear that Michael Jackson passed away.
News cannot confirm this, but Associated Press has just reported a person with knowledge of the situation says Michael Jackson has died.
Breaking news about Michael Jackson. Now, in the past few minutes, the Los Angeles Times and the Associated Press have reported that Jackson has died.
First confirmation, LA Times, then Associated Press, and now NBC News is confirming this word.
LA coroner reporting that Michael Jackson has died.
Can you remember where you were when you heard this news? I can't even remember myself when Twin Towers collapsed. There's a moment and time stops. Is that, did that happen to you at this point?
Yeah, yeah. I was on a jet ski just off an island.
It's a hard life.
It is a hard life, yeah. Yeah, I really was. My friend got a... I was on a jet ski, sorry. But my friend got a text and he was like, oh, Michael Jackson's died. And I was like, no. I was on a jet ski just off an island.
It's a hard life.
It is a hard life, yeah. Yeah, I really was. My friend got a... I was on a jet ski, sorry. But my friend got a text and he was like, oh, Michael Jackson's died. And I was like, no, he hasn't. It'll just be one of those internet rumors. And that's where I was. Where were you?
Well, I don't remember.
You can't. Seriously, you can't.
I was not on a jet ski. I do know that.
I was in a bar in London. And the staff came to me and I... Do you know Michael Jackson? As if I was a relative.
Right,
but,
right.
But people felt that
you
all
look
over the
a lot
world.
Like him.
Yeah,
actually.
I know. But I did some work. But yeah. It worked out. Let's hear something from Morning Sun. We have a bit of audio. The world don't love you anymore.
Yeah.
Did you ever feel that way about yourself?
Well, I'm a bit of a drama queen, aren't I, really? Yeah. You know, it's a bit, it's a tad dramatic. But, you know, at some points it's felt like that, yeah. But only because, you know, I'm an Olympic-sized warrior. And it's where my head takes me sometimes.
We're going to listen to the first song, I think.
Yeah, you're going to perform.
Okay.
Three songs. So, cool.
If you like to.
The band's ready for you.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, question. Yeah, I know.
You've got my shoes on.
I know. No, you got my shoes on.
Wow. Where did we get these from?
Yeah, I know. L.A. Well, we'll talk about it later. Okay. Okay, ik zei al dat het een hele bijzondere avond zou worden. Gaat voor ons drie nummers doen. Maar eerst natuurlijk het nummer wat zijn nieuwe album heeft geïntroduceerd, Bodies.
Nou en of. Het heeft 4 weken op 1 gestaan hier in Nederland. Het was een nummer 1 hit in Oostenrijk, Duitsland, Italië, Zwitserland. De top 10 hit. Nou ja, de rest van de wereld. De opnames van de clip hebben plaatsgevonden in Mojave Desert in Californië. En straks laten we die clip nog even zien. Er zit een bijzondere dame in. Kondig jij maar aan, hè? Dat wou je.
Are you ready?
Of course.
Great. Dames en heren, Robbie Williams.
The sunshine, then show me my lifeline. I was told it was all mine, then I got laid on a ley line. What a day, what a day, and then Jesus really died for me. I guess Jesus really tried for me. UK and entropy, I feel like it's fucking me. Wanna feed up the energy, love living like a deity. One day, and then Jesus really died for me. I guess Jesus really tried for me. Bodies in the poetry, bodies making chemistry. Bodies in my family, bodies in the way of me. Bodies in the cemetery, and that's the way it's gonna be. Who wants us to look good naked? Who can someone can take it? Cause it's strange to get stranger, and everything's contagious. It's the modern middle ages, all day, every day. And then Jesus really died for me. I guess Jesus really tried for me. Bodies in the poetry, bodies making chemistry. Bodies of my family, bodies in the way of me. Bodies in the cemetery, and that's the way it's gonna be. All we ever wanted to look at me, yeah, look at someone to take it. God save me, rejection from my reflection. I want perfection. Yeah! Bodies to the Bodhi tree. Bodies making chemistry. Bodies in my family. Bodies in the way of me. Bodies in
Cool.
Ah, right.
Dank je.
Het is waanzinnig dat hij hier is, Robbie Williams. Straks zijn we uiteraard terug met nog veel meer van deze man. Hij gaat nog optreden, we gaan hem nog allemaal leuke dingen vragen. Kortom, dit mag je niet missen. Tot zo.
Blijf kijken naar RTL Boulevard, want straks gaat Robbie los over zijn leven in de afkikkliniek.
It's just simply a case of not wanting to die, really. That's pre-rehab. I think that's where most people are on the way out.
Showt hij zijn Take That tattoo.
Yeah, I got this. I made friends with my friends from Take That. Ah. And we had this big meeting.
En wordt de wereldster verlegen als we het over zijn vriendin hebben.
You're looking different now.
Yeah, I'm embarrassed.
You're looking in love. That's what it is.
Yeah, and I'm embarrassed. I've gone really shy now for some reason.
Boulevard met Robbie Williams. Hij gaat zo meteen nog voor ons optreden, maar eerst gaan we het hebben over zijn hobby's. En die hobby's zijn
even, want jij zegt dat nou, maar you didn't know it was a special with you?
No, I didn't.
You just said.
No, I didn't. If I was, I'd have been more prepared for the heavy hitting questions
yeah,
that
heavy.
You've got.
What,
it is. I thought it was just going to be.
What would you have done different then? What would you have done different?
Well, I'd have just nothing, I suppose.
No.
Okay. Well, I was just starting to say that we were going to talk about your hobbies: football, tattoos, and UFOs.
Yes.
Are these three
not
correct?
Necessarily in that order, yeah.
Well, for us, yes.
What's your team? What's your team?
Well, I'm Ajax.
Ajax,
Amsterdam.
PSV.
PSV, okay.
And you?
A little team called Port Vale and a big team called Manchester United.
Ah.
Yeah, yeah.
And do you sponsor football as well?
I kind of... I'm like the majority shareholder of Port Vale.
Yeah, which I wouldn't think Manchester, no.
Well, actually, they're like $700 million in debt or something, Manchester United.
So don't do that.
No, God, no, not
okay,
at all.
To Port Vale, this is a little club. Mm-hmm. This is where all the passion goes to, right?
Well, yeah, basically what it was people are always trying to buy Port Vale and then sell the ground. So I put in enough money to make sure that they don't have to sell the ground. I'm not in there day to day with the running of things or making decisions or anything. It was just basically a little bit of charity to stop people buying the ground and then selling it.
And why that club?
Because my dad ran Port Vale Social Club when I was a kid, and I was born in a pub that is literally a stone's throw from the ground. So that's why.
And is it always a bit of a homecoming when you're there? It's so near to your roots then.
Yeah, I haven't been back for a while, actually. I went to watch them. I took my girlfriend, this is how very romantic I am. On Valentine's Day, I took her to watch Port Vale versus Brentford.
How did that go? So you wake up, some flowers, and you say, I got something very special for you. Today, you can join me for a football match.
She loves it.
How did that go? So you wake up, some flowers, and you say, I got something very special for you. Today, you can join me for a football match.
She loves it. They don't have to sell the ground. I'm not in there day to day with the running of things or making decisions or anything. It was just basically a little bit of charity to stop people buying the ground and then selling it.
And why that club?
Because my dad ran Port Vale Social Club when I was a kid, and I was born in a pub that is literally a stone's throw from the ground. So that's why.
And is it always a bit of a homecoming when you're there? It's so near to your roots then.
Yeah, I haven't been back for a while, actually. I went to watch them. I took my girlfriend, this is how very romantic I am. On Valentine's Day, I took her to watch Port Vale versus Brentford.
How did that go? So you wake up, some flowers, and you say, I got something very special for you. Today, you can join me for a football match.
She loves it. She just thinks that, that's the English version of romance, and in a way it is.
And you don't make her wiser than she is, then?
Yeah, no, don't. She's here. Let's not tell her.
Oh, she's here. Well, we talk about her later.
Okay.
But first, we have some footage of you playing football.
Okay. Oh, God.
Where is this?
So tell us a little bit of
Old Trafford. This is Soccer Aid. And, oh, that's in Los Angeles. That's my team, LA Vale. And I'm injured. That's, oh.
And this is, I think this is from a tour about 9 years ago. And he drags it past him, brings it to the keeper. He's only put it in the back of the net! Glorious!
Did you ever want to be a professional football player?
Yeah, but I'm crap. I wasn't very good at football. You know, I thought I was better than I was, and I'm just, you know, I'm just not.
It's good what you do there.
Yeah, and I would have loved to have been a professional footballer, but I was just nowhere near good enough, unfortunately.
But do you train a lot? Because when you were singing the song, you were dancing like this and everything. And is it a lot of training that you do?
Yeah, he did like this.
That's exactly how I did it. I haven't been training just recently, but I'm vowed to get back in the gym as soon as I get home. I'm going to start boxing again and get fit, because the knee went. The knee. When you turn, how old are you?
33.
And do you play football?
No.
Do you keep fit?
I box every now and then.
You box. And do things on your body, have you noticed that they've broken down a little bit after you reach 30?
Everything.
me and you both.
This is it, man.
I know, yeah. I know. But me too. That's why I need to get
but
back
boxing
in the gym.
Works, so that's
and
a good
that's
idea.
What I'm going to do. But since I've been 30, the knee's gone, the groin's gone. Not too far. The back's gone.
So you're an old man.
Yeah, I know. And
but
it takes.
Does a massage come in every day or something? Or just to keep you
fit?
Yeah,
but I get too bored. I can't sit down for that long. But I do notice that once you get to 30, things start getting difficult, start taking a long time to repair.
Ah, well, no.
It's always either you completely focus on sporting. I can't imagine you do that just
I'm either
before
completely
touring
focused
or something.
On yeah. getting myself fit or really focused on eating chocolate. It's one of the two things that I focus the most on.
But okay. Robbie, everybody is. I am watching and see as a fit man. I don't believe it, that everything is. Robbie Williams falling down. It isn't possible.
Well,
did you collapse?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. The body started to give in, but I've battered it over the years.
Okay.
So.
Well, talking about the body, second hobby of yours, or maybe something you like is better to say, tattoos.
Tattoos.
First
one I got was here. Hanky Panky.
Hanky Panky?
Yeah. At Hanky Panky's. He didn't do the tattoo, but it's a Celtic cross that I've got on my thigh, and that was the first tattoo that I got when I was 17. It was over here. And then I got another Maori one down the side here, and that was done over here too.
And did you on purpose go to Hanky Panky, or was this something you were in Amsterdam and you said, well, why not do it today?
Yeah, I didn't even think about it up until the moment I went, I fancy getting a tattoo.
We spoke, Hanky Panky. Oh, nice picture. This is not Hanky Panky.
Who's this?
Where's that?
That was before the body was falling down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't even know where that is, or I know that's me, obviously.
Yeah.
But I can't remember. No, yeah, that's that one.
Is there sometimes a tattoo that you regret, that you think, oh, I want to wipe that away?
No. No, not at all. I love them all. I got this. I made friends with my friends from Take That.
Ah.
And we had this big meeting. And they came to my house and I sat down and I went, right, this is what you did that I didn't like. And they went, okay, I'm sorry. And then the others, and then they went to me, this is what you did that I didn't like. And I went, I'm sorry. And then we became really good friends. And it's a really beautiful moment. And I thought that I'd go and celebrate that moment by getting the Take That symbol tattooed on my arm.
That's great.
It's not the end of the story. It's not the end of the story. The next day, they come up to my house because we're just about to have a party and celebrate us all being friends again. And I went, hey, lads, look at this. And all of them in synchronicity went, ah, you knob. Which means dickhead. and I have to agree with them. But yeah, I think it's a nice thing.
It's nice. And we spoke Hanky Panky. Let's look at him.
In de loop der jaren verzamelt Robbie bijna net zoveel gouden platen aan zijn muur als tatoeages op zijn behaarde lijf. I don't wanna rock,
DJ. Het heeft een mannelijk gehalte, om het maar zo te noemen. Het is niet echt door elkaar in. Er zit wel een bepaalde lijn in. En er zit ook wel een stukje tattoo fashion in, hoor. Want als je bijvoorbeeld in de voetbalwereld kijkt, zie je heel veel van dit soort tatoeages. Onderarm, moeder stond er heel groot op zondag. Singing in the classes, music for your
masses. Good no head, no backstage passes. Eigenhandig revivalt Good Old Rob een hele vergeten tattoo-cultuur door het zetten van een mega Maori-tattoo op zijn schouder.
Het feit dat hij dat ding heeft genomen, heeft de Maori-tatoeage zo ontzettend populair gemaakt in Europa.
In één week komt er misschien wel gewoon één of twee man voor een Maori. En meestal brengen ze gewoon ook het plaatje van Robbie Williams mee. Ja, ja. Ja, ik wil het graag zo. Ja.
Het grootste orgaan van de ster, zijn huid, is nog lang niet volledig ondergekrabbeld. Er kan zeker nog meer bij.
Dit is al behoorlijk wat. Dit is op zich wel veel. Maar kan meer. Er zijn heel veel lege plekken. Kan meer.
Ja, een marriage tattoo.
Ik denk dat een pin-up wel cool is bij hem.
Wat dan?
Check een dikke tieten.
Na het jaren subsidiëren van de voltallige tattoo-industrie vindt Henkie Pankie het tijd geworden voor een bedankmomentje.
Mr. Williams, Sir Robbie Williams. For your collection, I didn't have time to frame it, but I inked it last night. And it's the sweetest girl I ever kissed. Another man's wife, my mother. Your mother.
Oh, huh? Oh. Yes.
Beautiful.
That's cool, huh?
Oh, wow, that's really cool. Thank you very much. Thank you. Cool. Thanks
okay,
a lot,
Robbie,
that's amazing.
And a girl with big tits, are you going to do that?
I think I might do, actually.
Yeah, okay.
is that his daughter?
Yeah.
I might get her to do it.
She's
on the tour. One thing is a bit weird with the tattoos is when I'm at a concert and I look out into the front and sometimes some ladies have exactly the same tattoos as me. And that is so weird to look.
And they're going like this,
they're going like that, and they're going... No, no. Yeah, but no.
Okay, earlier you talked about the new symbol on your wrist, friendship symbol.
Mm-hmm.
Children in Need in London a couple of weeks ago, there was this special moment, everybody talked about it in the world. Not real reunion, but you were on stage together. From that point, you got together, you talked about everything. Is there in the near future somewhere a moment where we will see you all together again on a stage?
Yeah, I hope so. I don't know when and where and how it's going to be.
But it's going to happen.
Oh, look at us there. Mm. God bless us all.
Yeah. That was emotional for you, huh?
Yeah, really emotional. And we should have milked it for a lot longer. I was up there going, yeah, this is ace. And then they all just walked off.
Well, we take you there for a couple of
seconds. We have to take a moment.
A good reason to be back in the band.
I know. But is there a straight answer? Can you say this will happen next year?
I don't. Yeah, something will happen next year. Yeah, and I don't know what it is yet, though.
But are you going to be recording together again?
I would hope so. I would hope that would be the case. But we shall see.
Okay. And what's
I genuinely don't know the answer to it. So I'm not. Not trying to be vague on purpose. I just don't know.
No. And when you talk together about everything that separated you the last years, what was the biggest thing that was negative about it? That you stayed apart.
It was our formative years, growing up. You know, and there was an awful lot of things that happened in the band that I didn't like. And there's not much that I can actually talk about because I get sued by various different people. I thought we were treated unfairly. And in the process, you know, there was a lot of stuff, none that I could talk about because, you know, I get sued an awful lot. So, you know, it was just It was five boys growing up, and we all loved each other. And somewhere down the line, we split apart, and it was a very sad and unfortunate time for us all. But you know, it's like a fairy tale ending right now.
Well, so it's all good. In the end, it's all about music, and we are glad that you're going to perform another song for us. So again,
if your body is ready for it.
My body is ready for
it. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Volgende nummer dat hij voor ons gaat zingen, ook van zijn laatste album, is You Know Me. En Albert die weet daar weer meer van te vertellen.
Ja, nee, het is gewoon heerlijk. Ik vind het zo ontzettend. Vind je het ook een ontzettend leuke kerel?
Ja, hè?
Zo open, zo vrolijk, zo into Boulevard. Hij vond het ook echt leuk om hier via later weer te zijn. En we zien hem eigenlijk wel waarom. We gaan gewoon lekker luisteren naar de optreden. You know. Juist, You Know Me, Robbie Williams.
On fantasy, then to only breed in captivity is pointless.
Thank you.
Well, I've been doing what I like, when I like, how I like, it's joyless. Only you know me. What a waste of what this piece, baby, steps into my sleeps. Till I get to say sorry, I get hysterical, historical. Love is just chemicals. Give us something to stop me. Only you know me. Since you went away, my heart breaks every day. You don't know, 'cause you're not there. What are you thinking? I done bruised up my mind with this Thunderbird wine. Baby, I'm drinking. Only you know me. Since you went away, my heart breaks every day.
Well, Robbie, I was...
This is the newest single, eh? You Know Me van het album Reality Killed the Video Star.
I was just thinking.
Thank you very much.
This is kind of romantic, right?
Yeah.
Who gave that to you? Who's that?
Let me just... You've got three! Oh, let me just give you... I don't know why I'm talking into this like it's a mic. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. I like the sound. One for each of us. There's one for you. One for you.
Well, you can
get the one with
the card. You can get one with the address on it.
There we go.
Okay, good. Well, what I think is nice to see that in all these years, also the fans turn older.
Yeah, don't tell them that. Dear Robbie, what I would like to do to you backstage. I can't read this out on television. No. I mean, I'm in Holland. I can actually read this out on television.
Did, not. Okay. Did the fans keep in touch the last 3 years? Did you still have contact with your fans and everything? Or were they just not there?
Online, I think.
They were there online, yeah. And, you know, when I went into rehab, I got an awful lot of letters wishing me luck and everything, so thank you very much, whoever sent them and whenever they were sent. Yeah, they made their presence known when I've needed the most support, yeah.
You're very open about that, being in rehab.
Yeah.
Everybody knows?
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody goes now, don't they? It's not no big news, really. No. Everybody pops off to rehab. I'm just one of many.
And comes back stronger.
Yeah, if you like, yeah.
Well, it's great
to have you. Is it very confrontating when you're... What is rehab? I don't know what it is. I've never been there.
Oh, it's not fun. It's basically a hospital that you go to... It's a hospital that, you know, you wake up in the morning, 6 o'clock, go down, go get your porridge, have a cup of tea, and then you spend the rest of the day going in and out of different classes, you know, and talking about your problems, and it's all very therapeutic and blah, 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 blah. And you're there for ages and it's really boring.
Well, it's... But you're a hero when you do that.
Really?
I think so.
Well, I'm here with them. Well, it's just simply a case of not wanting to die, really. That's pre-rehab. I think that's where most people are on the way out. And fortunately, you know, I've got great management that love me very much. And they came in one fateful day and picked me up and put me on a plane and made me go. And I really needed to go. So, you know, all the thanks go. I've needed the most support, yeah.
You're very open about that, being in rehab.
Yeah.
Everybody knows?
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody goes now, don't they? No big news, really. No. Everybody pops off to rehab. I'm just one of many.
And comes back stronger.
Yeah. If you like, yeah.
Well, it's great to have you.
Is it very confrontating when you're... What is rehab? I don't know what it is. I've never been there.
Oh, it's not fun. It's basically a hospital that you go to... It's a hospital that, you know, you wake up in the morning, 6 o'clock, go down, go get your porridge, have a cup of tea, and then you spend the rest of the day going in and out of different classes, you know, and talking about your problems, and it's all very therapeutic and blah, 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 blah. And you're there for ages, and it's really boring.
Well, it's... But you're a hero when you do that.
Really?
I think so.
Well, I'm here with them. Well, it's just simply a case of not wanting to die, really. That's pre-rehab. I think that's where most people are on the way out. And fortunately, you know, I've got great management that love me very much. And they came in one fateful day and picked me up and put me on a plane and made me go. And I really needed to go. So, you know, all the thanks goes to them, really, for being there for me.
Great.
Good.
Yeah.
Okay. Zometeen zijn we terug met meer Robbie Williams. Dan gaan we het onder andere ook nog even hebben over de liefde. En hij gaat nogmaals voor ons zingen. Tot zo.
Na de reclame zingt Robbie zijn allergrootste hit. I just wanna feel real.
verrassing heeft hij zijn vriendin meegenomen naar RTL Boulevard.
She's here somewhere, right?
Yeah, so she's back there. You got okay. The camera. Oh, she's okay. Somewhere.
We kijken steeds naar een speciale RTL Boulevard helemaal met Robbie Williams. Het is een eer om hem hier te hebben. It's an honor to have you here.
Thanks,
great
man.
Performances so far. Later
Thank
on,
you.
You're going to play a song everybody knows, Feel.
Okay.
Which is all about, the way you feel for somebody else.
You're getting soft now.
No.
Oh, is this like a good guy, bad guy routine normally?
Well, yeah. Normally, yeah.
He's a good guy and I'm a bit of a false bitch.
And he goes like bam, bam.
Oh, really? Is that the truth? Is that the truth? Oh, okay.
You see, cool. I never lie.
You're both being good cops, though, tonight. I like
yeah,
it.
Yeah, we are.
Okay, we asked the audience and not only the fans to send us some questions for you.
Okay.
And I think you have the
first
one.
This is a nice one. If you one day have a son or daughter, do you want her or him to become a pop star?
Or would you mind?
I wouldn't mind, no, not at all. Whatever he or her is happy doing, I'd be happy supporting. Yeah.
But you won't say, no, don't do that because all the trouble and...
No, God, no, not at all.
All if the money you make, you don't want that.
No, keep it. No, not at all. Hopefully I'd have done a good enough job for them not to want to be a pop star, though. Yeah. But if they do, if they want to sing and dance and, you know, entertain people, then yeah, I shall back them 100%, yeah.
Yeah. So, talking about children, in September we spoke each other in London, and I asked you the following question. Are you also thinking of family, children? Is this something which you think about?
Yeah, talk about it a lot.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, it's the best thing it can happen to you. I'm just had a child for 1 year. I was never into children.
Really?
But once it happens, it really
changes. Did you think you were not going to have one?
Yes. I was.
Me too.
People started talking about children, I walked away.
Yeah.
And now I have one. It's great.
Boy or a girl?
Boy.
What's his name?
Julian.
Julian.
It's a great guy.
Cool. How old are you?
I'm 32.
32?
Yeah.
It's about time I knocked one out, really, isn't it?
Yeah, you should.
36. Am I 36? I'm 35. Oh, thank God.
So, any changes yet? Are you still, like, practicing, or are you already into...
I'm doing a lot of practicing, yeah. I'm getting really, really good at it.
No, but it is true that once you start talking about it, the moment is coming nearer and nearer.
How old's Julian now, then?
One.
One?
Yeah.
And how much sleep are you getting now?
I get all the sleep I want.
No, seriously, are you not a very hands-on dad, or...?
I am, but he sleeps a lot, so that's not a reason not to take kids for you.
Really? Wasn't the first year, like, really, really,
yes,
really hot?
Yes, it was. You came in with eyes like this and
big bags.
I'm so sleepy.
Is that the reason? One of the reasons you still wait, or...? You're afraid of that?
No, first you had to have a girlfriend. Now you have a girlfriend.
Yeah, I mean, I've been going out with my missus now for 3 years. Solidly in the relationship for about 1.5 years. And I want to play around and have more fun and not be grown-ups yet.
Because you're doing a lot of things together. You travel and you do all kind. Is it that you want to enjoy every moment with her, because you know all those years before here you were always working?
Yeah, we you know, she makes my life nice. I like being around her and she likes being around me, because we love each other, you know. And it's a very, very cool thing, and that's why she's with me all the time. There she is, bless her, on the screen. And yeah, I don't know, I've gone all coy and shy now.
But how did you meet? Because I asked this, when you're famous, when you're Robbie Williams, I think that it's very hard to recognize if somebody loves you or loves the star Robbie Williams. Do you know what I mean? So how did you
how
meet?
Did you find out?
What was the click that you had together?
I just think you know. You know, it's not a... I don't know, I never went into any... start a relationship, if you like, thinking, does she like me for me or for the things I have, you know, because, you know, this is going to sound big-headed, but I'm a pretty cool guy without all of this stuff anyway, you know. And she digs me and I dig her, and, you know, she knows who I am and I know who she is, and You know, I trust her 100%. There isn't even a glimmer of worried about who, you know, liking me for all of this singing malarkey.
What kind of little things makes you happy? Like sitting on the couch together, simple things? What is that?
Yeah, it's, oh God, this is going to sound so slushy, isn't it? You know, cuddles and tickles and the television with the cuddles and the tickles. It's the little things and the cuddles and the tickles and the doggies and, you know, it's those things. So embarrassing.
She's here somewhere, right?
That's so embarrassing. Yeah, no, she's back there. You got okay. The camera. Oh, she's
somewhere. Do you travel a lot together when you're doing performances? Well, you're looking different now.
Yeah, I'm embarrassed.
You're looking in love. That's what it is.
Yeah, and I'm embarrassed. I've gone really shy now for some reason. Yeah, we traveled. I thought they were going to play like a ballad or something. Yeah, we dig each other. I've got really shy. God. Excuse me. Sorry.
What do you recognize in her that you like, and what does she recognize in you that she likes in you? First, you about her.
Well, yeah. You know, when you start in a relationship, for me, you're always like, well, you know. This is good, this one that you're being now, but normally in about 3 months' time I'm going to see the real you, you know, and you're going to see the real me, and, you know, it maybe isn't who we are pretending to be right now. But nobody changed. I didn't change, she didn't change, and, you know, she's, it's... God, I'm so embarrassed talking
about
it.
No, but that's why? Not, why? Because that's what happens in a relationship, that you first try to change each other, and then you think, no, we needn't do that, because we love each other for who we are.
Yeah, no, I'm more along the lines of, you know, the person that walked into my life stayed the same person that she was, and, you know, we don't fall out, and we have nothing to fall out about, we don't have arguments. We just get on and we make each other laugh, and, you know, it's we're a good team.
That's great.
Yeah.
Is it difficult because he has the same problem? He is a very popular young guy in Holland, and right. And he has a beautiful girlfriend, and everybody's talking, when are you getting married? Isn't that... I'm gay, so I don't have the problem. But...
He's the only gay in the village.
Yeah,
you're the only gay in the village.
Yes, I am. No, but is it
you're
difficult?
You're very butch for a gay.
Thank you very
you
much.
You are.
I always thought
yeah.
so.
Yeah,
but,
you are.
No, but is it
you're
difficult?
Very butch for a gay.
Thank you very
you
much.
You are.
I always thought
yeah.
so.
Yeah,
but,
you are.
No, but I think when you're a man and a woman, the press and the gossip always think, when are you going to be married? When are you going to be engaged? When are you going to be children? That's so hard, I think, when you're just trying to love each other without all the
Well, no, it's not really, because it's a separate entity. It doesn't exist if you don't read it, does it? You know, and who cares what they say or think or want? You know, it's just part of the script of your story, I suppose. The engagement, the marriage, the kids, da-da. Have you got a partner?
Yes, and we are married, two men.
Oh, right, okay.
It's possible in Holland. So
cool.
For
how long have you been?
8 years now, and we are 18 years together.
Really? And yeah. do you have arguments and stuff?
Yes, we have.
Are they
no,
bad ones?
No, no, they're good ones. We keep each other awake with the minds, just
and
talking.
Do you see each other a lot?
Well, each night 1 hour at the kitchen table, but in the summer,
right.
In the summer we have a lot
and
of
what does he do?
He's a politician.
He's a politician?
Yeah.
Come on, Holland, that's why I love you. Brilliant.
Yeah.
And how long
brilliant.
Have you been going out with your missus?
Over 10 years.
And they want you to get, the media or whoever wants you to get married?
No, I proposed.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah.
When did you do that?
In June on Times Square.
Oh,
and
really?
Something about, you know, the board on...
Oh, yeah, and the big, like, the screen and the picture
oh,
was there.
Oh, wow.
It was fun, yeah. Good
that's
idea.
Would you do that? Yeah, I would do. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's really cool.
Yeah,
well
I'll
thought.
Give you the number later on. Oh,
so you're
yeah.
very, very romantic.
I know.
And yeah. when is the wedding? Oh, you won't see on the telly, of course. But it's...
Somewhere in summer.
Somewhere in summer, okay.
Yeah.
Good luck, mate. Well done.
It's so much fun that we got to know each other a lot better than we did before the show started. I think you know Robbie better than before the show started, didn't you? You're a great guy.
Thank you.
This is a great album, Reality Kill the Theater Star. And
before we send him back to the podium, we have a surprise.
The classics.
A surprise.
Oh yeah. You do it.
Oh, come on.
$25,000.
Thank you.
It's the first.
Brilliant.
Good, huh?
Excellent. Thanks, guys.
Congrats.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, Robbie. It.
Am I going to go?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll keep it for you here. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
It was great to have you on the show.
Brilliant. Loved it.
Yeah. Heerlijk.
Ja, dan toch, toch dat nummer maar, hè?
Ja, dat nummer. Albert wilde het eigenlijk heel graag. Het is een nummer dat iedereen kent. Het is ja, toch wel echt de Robbie Williams die we al jaren kennen. Feel.
Feel. Lekker toch? Feel. Ja. Gaan we staan. Mr. Robbie Williams.
Come and hold my hand. I wanna contact the living. Not sure I understand. This rule I've been given. I sit and talk to God. She just laughs at my plan. My head speaks a language I don't understand. I got too much love running through my veins, going to waste. I don't wanna die, but I ain't keen on living either. Before I fall in love, I'm preparing to leave her. Kill myself today. That's why I keep on running before I arrive. I can see myself coming. Too much love running through my veins, going to waste.
bless you.
RTL Boulevard Special Robbie Williams werd mede mogelijk gemaakt door Radio 53.